In this video, we are going to show you a couple of ideas for early rehab after Achilles tendon rupture repair.
Get our very own assessment ebook and mobile app. Links are in the video description.
Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. The Achilles tendon, being the biggest and strongest tendon in the human body, is formed by the tendons of the soleus and gastrocnemius muscles, which both insert at the calcaneus. We mostly see ruptures of the Achilles tendon in high-impact sports, predominantly in the male athlete. While a scientific review from the year 2017 showed no significant differences in the outcomes of surgical and conservative management, the re-rupture rate of conservatively managed tendons was higher, and conservative management might not be suitable for every injury depending on its severity. However, there is a clear benefit of an accelerated rehab program, including early mobilization versus immobilization, as has been researched by Brumann and colleagues in 2014. In the first phase post-surgery, usually lasting about 2 weeks, the goal should be to properly educate the patient on the expected course, make sure that the wound heals properly and swelling is under control. The patient will likely wear a walker boot with 30 degrees of plantar flexion, but should be able to walk with full weight bearing. Your aim is going to be to strengthen the surrounding muscles, so let's look at what this could look like.
Asking the patient to move the toes into extension and flexion can be a great way to engage ankle and foot motion early on. A simple straight leg raise in supine lying position, even with the walker boot still on, or with additional ankle weights, can be performed by the patient. In order to keep the glutes in good condition for later weight bearing, you can do something like clamshells without resistance, or by adding a dyna loop around the knees for further resistance. Another pillar non-weight bearing glute exercise are side lying abductions. You can perform those without resistance, with an additional ankle weight, or you can use a dyna loop above the knees to apply resistance.
In order to be able to progress to the second phase, the patient should be pain-free in rest and swelling does not increase. Check out phase 2 in the video to my left and give this video right here a like if you found it helpful. If you haven't subscribed to our channel yet, we urge you to do so as this helps us out a lot. Check the links in the video description for more Physiotutors goodness. And as always, this was Andreas for Physiotutors. I'll see you next time. Bye.